Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in Revit 2018 Metro. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_013_BIABN where you saved it. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save as icon. This will bring the save drawing as dialog box. If you plan to open this drawing in earlier version of AutoCAD, go and select that version. I'm going to select AutoCAD 2007 and rename this drawing to 00_014_BIABM and click the save button. Go to the view control and select custom view, select first floor plan. Go to the home tab layer panel and click the floor layer button. We need to move this line to the beyond layer. To do that, go to the home, go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property. Select this object and this object, press escape. Now type RE on your keyboard and select region in the window that appears. Still the line appears as a solid. To solve this problem, go to the property panel, click the down arrow and select the other. In the light type manager, click the show detail button. Now change the scale of the line type. You have two different scales. You have the global scale and the current object scale. Go and change the scale, the global scale to 2 and press OK. Type region, type RE on the keyboard and select the region all. Zoom in to see the result. Press escape. Press enter to repeat. Go to the property panel again and select order. Now change the global scale to 10, click OK. Now the line display a little bit better. Let's draw a line in the center layer to see how it looks with these global changes. By going to the home tab, draw panel, select the line command. Draw a line anywhere, press escape. I think the changes is OK. Let's go again and change the global scale factor to 20 and see the result. Go to the home tab, properties panel, click the down arrow and select the order. If you don't see this option, click the show detail and change the global scale factor to 20. Click the OK button. Now the beyond line display the way we expect it to be. Select this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Now go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property. Select this object and select this object. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. And specify offset distance prompt. Type 1000 on your keyboard. Press enter. Zoom in into this area. Select this line and offset it to the right. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the express tool tab. Draw panel and select the break line symbol command. Select the size option or type S on your keyboard and press enter. Type 1200 mm, press enter. Type E on your keyboard, press enter. Type 600 and press enter. At specifying first point of break line point, click at the end point of this line. Now move the mouse cursor, use a perpendicular object snap and click in this area. Press enter. Go to the express tool tab, draw panel and select the break line symbol command. At specifying first point for break line or block size extension point, type S on your keyboard and press enter. Type 150, press enter. Type E, press enter. Type 150, press enter. At specifying first point for break line point, zoom in into this area and snap to this point. Move to this area and snap. At the specified location for break symbol prompt, press enter. Now go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 150 on your keyboard, press enter. Select this line, offset it up, select this line, offset it up. Press escape. Select the break symbol. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the copy command. Zoom in into this area, click on this endpoint and move the mouse cursor, use the perpendicular object snap to snap at this point. Use move up and snap to this other point. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select these lines and hit delete on your keyboard. Select the break symbol, hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the home tab, draw a panel and select the line command. At the specified first point prompt, click at the end point of the break symbol. Go to the status bar and turn off the auto mode. Hover the mouse cursor into this area and type 500. Press enter. Press escape. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 150 and press enter. Select this line and offset it up. Press escape. I want the space between the two break lines to be 150 apart. Now, go to the home tab, modify panel, click down arrow and select the extend command. Press enter. Extend this line up. Press escape. Go to the home tab, drop panel and select the line command. At specifying first object prompt, click at this vertex, move the mouse cursor and cross the line that you just draw, click, press escape, select the break symbol, go to the home tab, modify panel and select the move command. At specify base point prompt, use this vertex as a base point, move the mouse cursor and snap to the intersection of this line, press escape to get out of command. Now select this line, and this line, hit delete on your keyboard. Go to the home tab, modify panel, click this arrow and select the trim command. Press enter, trim off this line and this line. Press escape. Select this line, go to the home tab, modify panel and select the move command. Click on this vertex and move to the right. Now go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 500 on your keyboard and press enter. Select the break symbol and offset it into this direction. Press escape. Now select this break symbol. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the copy command. At specify base point prompt, use the endpoint object snap and snap to this point and move it and copy it to this other line. Press escape. Select this line and hit delete symbol. Now select this. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the move command. At specify base point prompt, click on this area, move, make sure that your auto mode is turned on and eyeball the movement of the break symbol. Click. Go to the home tab, modify panel, select the trim command. At the select source object prompt, press enter. Trim off this line, this line, this line, this line. Press escape. Now go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property. At the select source object prompt, select this line and select this line as the select destination object prompt. Select this line. Now go to the home tab, modify panel and select the fillet command. Type M on your keyboard. Press enter. Fillet this line to this line. Fillet this line to this line. Fillet this line to this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Select this line and hit delete on your keyboard. Select this line, hit delete on your keyboard. Select this line and click on this grid. Use the perpendicular object snap and snap to this line. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property. At the select source object prompt, select this line. At select destination object prompt, select this line and this line. Press escape to get out of the command. When you look at this line, it appears as a solid line, but it is not a solid line. If you select the line and look at the line type, you see the dashed line on the layer. So to correct this problem, click this down arrow and select other. Select, if you don't see this detail, click on this button, show details, then change the global scale factor to 20 and click OK. Now the lines display like to expect them to display. Go to the view control and select the first floor. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button. All right, we're going to stop this tutorial at this moment. In the next tutorial, we'll start to dimension our objects. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friends. If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue on this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please click the subscribe button. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.